Hi, this is Dr. Nirmala speaking to you. I'm a consultant infertility specialist and clinical director, Manipal Fertility, JP Nagar. I have been into the practice of IVF since 1998. Yes, it has a decent role to play. Though I already mentioned that 80% it is the embryo, about easily 10 to 15% it is the endometrium which is at fault. And we just saw why the endometrium can go at fault. There could be various disorders, pathologies inside the uterus, which we just spoke about, and we also spoke about the corrective measures towards it. Now, beyond that, something which you cannot correct, which keeps happening, is what we call as a thin endometrium. Now, this is something which takes us by surprise, and it is one of the most distressing scenarios both for the clinician as well as for the patient, because you really do not know how to go about it. The causes for a thin endometrium could be multiple causes. Yes, it could be infections, as I stated earlier, or sometimes it is just a hit and run. There could have been some infection in the past. It's hit the endometrium, affected it, and it is not to be seen today. So we are facing the consequence of that particular trauma which has happened in the past. Now, there are congenital reasons for the thin endometrium, like the congenital abnormalities of the uterus, a woman with a chromosomal abnormality called Turner syndrome. The acquired ones are women who have undergone chemotherapy, radiotherapy, or some kind of an uterine procedure per se. Say, for example, she has had an adhesion, a band, and then she went through a procedure where you have curetted, you have removed that, and then again the adhesion has formed. A repeated kind of clearance of that could affect the endometrium. Rare scenarios you find in a woman who is coming and trying for the second baby, she has had maybe an abortion in the past and some kind of an overzealous curetting or what you call commonly as dilatation and curettage, DNC. So a overzealous DNC, you could affect the baseline of the uterus, and then the uterus refuses to budge and grow in the future cycles. So these are all the causes. So what can you do about that? Yes, so we change medications. There are plenty of protocols and medicines. Yes, we have been attempting to change the protocols and drugs. Apart from that, the thin endometrium, you could do a ERA, a receptivity, and if you still find the receptivity is good, we could go ahead and safely transfer embryos, and we have seen pregnancies. And the last thing that could also be attempted when endometrium is you want to give some kind of a correction on the endometrial front so that you have a better pregnancy rate, could be an endometrial scratch. This is one of the recent thought processes. And the reason behind a scratch, you just go in and scratch on the posterior wall of the uterus. In the typical sense, you just make two or three scratches. Now, this little trauma or injury that is being created onto the uterine lining is thought to improve on the inflammatory processes, and that healing which happens subsequent to that, the growth factors are poured in to bring about the healing, and it is those growth factors which are also contributing, which is also contributing to the bettered implantation. So that is the kind of thinking. Sometimes the same trauma could be also thought of by doing a procedure called hysteroscopy. It is under mild anaesthesia, putting a camera through the cervix into the uterus to check if the uterus interior is good. So that little trauma can also predispose to a better pregnancy rate.